Check. Check, check, check. What's going on? Can you guys hear this? Can you guys hear this? Let me know if you guys can hear this then. Fuck. Let me know. I think we're all right here. We had a small kink. Hello. 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 All right. There we go. Fucking great. Stupid mic. I got too hyped up in the tournament match that I had. All right, so at the quarterback spot here, we're talking about the, before, I guess, obviously, all I said. We're doing an impromptu live stream here because on Friday we did, we're supposed to do the Vols, but we didn't do it because we did the Chip Kelly rebuilds the Dallas Cowboys. I want to get this done this weekend, and I have about an hour of free time or so right now, so I figure let's hit this up and let's see what we can do and dominate with the Volunteers. As a Gator fan, it's a tough one to do. But, you know, we gotta do it. We gotta do all the teams. Next episode for those of you that don't give a shit about the Volunteers is the Texas Longhorns. We're doing them probably Tuesday. I know next week's gonna be crazy with draft week, but I'm gonna try to at least do one more of these episodes next week, and it will be the Longhorns. So at the quarterback spot, we got Peyton Manning here, 99 overall. As much as I hate Peyton Manning, he's one of the greatest quarterbacks of all time. The 99 was very easy to give him. He's one of the best college quarterbacks in the history. I mean, I haven't seen a... Realistically, for those of you young bucks out there, even me, man, I wasn't following football back in 98 when he got drafted. Pretty much him and Andrew Luck seemed like they were the two most refined quarterbacks, maybe even John Elway, to ever come out of college. Then we got Tyler Bray backing him up. He's nothing special, but Peyton Manning hopefully can bring us to the promised land. At the running back spot, we got Jamal Lewis. We got two very nice running backs here representing the Volunteers. We have Jamal Lewis, who most notably had a 2,000-yard rushing season with the Baltimore Ravens. He was a monster, so we gave him a 91 overall. Then we got Arian Foster. I watched the podcast he did with Joe Rogan, and it seemed like he was pretty lackadaisical at Tennessee. Maybe that's why he went undrafted, but then when he got to the NFL, he's the greatest running back in the history of the Houston, Texas organization. I know they're a new franchise, but still. So that's pretty good two-headed running back combination we have there. Fullback, because we're using the Bucs, we just kept the monster Mike Alstott on. At the wide receiver spot, we just went with three. Not a great wide receiver school by any means, but we got Cordarrelle Patterson, 92 overall. Was a first-round draft pick. I don't know if you want to say he's a bust. I personally believe he's a bust because he's been a great special teamer, but that's pretty much it. I don't know. Unless he can rejuvenate his career in Oakland where he signed in free agency, I think you pretty much have to say he's a bust because you don't use a first-round pick on a guy that's going to be a predominantly special teamer. We got Justin Hunter here, 90 overall. Another guy. Man, this guy, height, weight, speed, monster, bouncing around. I don't know where he is right now. I know he started out, he got drafted by the Tennessee Titans, and then he went to the Buffalo Bills, and I think he went somewhere else this year in free agency, but while I was in Tennessee, I remember this is back when we got the NCAA football games, and he was unstoppable. And then we have Denarius Moore, who kind of fell off a little bit, but had a couple productive seasons with the Oakland Raiders earlier on in his career, so these will be the three wide receivers that we're rolling with. Joey Kent was an honorable mention, but I just decided we'll go with the three more recent players. At the tight end position, we got Jason Witten, easy 99. I mean, the Peyton Manning and Jason Witten combination, even though it pains me to use that, I think it's going to be pretty unstoppable. As even when anytime we've used Jason Witten anytime on this channel, which is very sparingly, Witten is a monster for us. So I think it's going to be great things. We also got Michael Rivera and Luke Stalker representing Tennessee on this team as well. At left tackle, we're going with Dick Huffman, who's played back in Jesus Christ 1960s. But he was regarded as one of the best offensive linemen in the history of Tennessee, so we included him. Left guard, we have Ramon Foster, currently of the Pittsburgh Steelers. We gave him an 93. At center, we got Zach Fulton. I think he's on the Kansas City Chiefs. We gave him an 85. Right guard, James Stone. No idea. Rob Stone, too damn phone, I guess. 91 overall for this guy. And at right tackle, we got John Gordy, another legend. His Wikipedia page was the longest out of every guy. I had no idea who they were. So we decided to include him. He's more of a guard, though. That's definitely not his right height and weight. But we needed some offensive linemen here. Another team that doesn't have a great historical offensive line. The defense is terrifying on the Vols. The defense is absolutely terrifying. So we're starting, in my opinion, the greatest football player ever, any position, and that is Reggie White. We gave him a 99. I did really think about considering putting Derek Barnett on the team, but on the left right-hand spot, we got Doug Atkins, who was a member of the Chicago Bears legendary roster. I probably should include Derek Barnett because he did break Reggie White's record, but I only try to use current rookies when there isn't a legend in their place. But shout out to Derek Barnett for breaking Reggie White's sack record. Too bad there's not a chance in hell Derek Barnett is even as close as good as Reggie White was. A sack, over a sack average a game. Are you kidding me? Greatest player. Oh, yeah, we also got Robert Ayers there as well, another volunteer. Now I'll go to the defensive line. Interior, we got Malik Jackson for the Jacksonville Jaguars, Denver Broncos, wherever you want to consider him, 92. And we got Dan Williams, who's recently just released from the Oakland Raiders with an 87, but still a pretty good front four. Jumping in, we got Leonard Littrell, who was a legendary St. Louis Ram. I'm pretty sure he was a part of the defense during the Greatest Show on Turf era. We gave him a 97. He was one of the top linebackers. I remember back in the day in Madden, my buddy was a big-time Rams fan. This guy was a motherfucking asshole to deal with. Middle linebacker, we have Kurt Meggett. You put an F there and you get some other people on the YouTubes. But 84 overall. We could have used Andy Spiva. I guess he was some dude I never heard of. He got tragically killed in a car accident. But I figured let's just go with Kurt Meggett, who was pretty decent with Tennessee before he got injured. And then at right outside linebacker, we'll probably make the switch. We'll make Meggett an outside linebacker. And then we got the beast, Al Wilson, one of my favorite players in Madden history. This guy was a stud on the Denver Broncos. He was always, back in the day, like the highest overall free agent you could sign, because for some reason he was always a free agent, and he's always like 88, 89 free agent. But when he's on the field for the Denver Broncos, he was a monster. So, he's not naturally an outside linebacker. We'll have to switch him inside with the depth chart. Jump to the secondary, we have Terry McDaniel, multi-time pro bowler for the Volunteers. I think he's a four-time All-Pro. So we gave him 93 overall. We have Dale Carter, another legendary Volunteer, multiple Pro Bowls to his career in the NFL, and was very productive at Tennessee. And then we have Justin Coleman, who's I think is on the Patriots, kind of been a bust. But while he's in Tennessee, he got drafted, I think, in the first three rounds. So we helped you out there with a nice 87 overall. Going to the free safety, we have Eric Berry. We gave a 99, along with Jalen Ramsey. It's the best safety I've ever seen in college football. I'm gonna give him the number one safety I've ever seen play college. Him, Eric Berry, if I was making an all-time college team, he'd be maybe after Ndamukong Suh, my next pick on the defensive side of the ball. He was absolutely incredible in Tennessee. Has been very, very, very good for the Kansas City Chiefs in the NFL. Great story, overcoming cancer, and got paid this past offseason. Good for him. And then at strong safety, we have Bobby Majors, 92 overall guy, another dude that played back when, Jesus Christ, half the fucking league was in the war. I do know he played for Philadelphia for a couple seasons, and he's a legend, it seems, for Volunteer fans, so we included him as our strong safety. So let's rock and roll, baby! We're going to sim to the half-season point, and we'll see where we're going. We might have to sim a couple more games if it's looking like we're making a playoff push, because as I said, I got probably 45 minutes before I got to bounce. Majit. Oh shit, John Henderson was a Volunteer? Why did not I include the... He's in my fucking notes! Reggie White was better with the Packers than the Eagles. That'd be funny. Like, that'd be a good troll if there was any validity behind that. He statistically wasn't better. He was on a better team, maybe. But statistically, you give me Reggie White in, like, I don't know, 88? Whew! Best defensive player ever. And I say that with, like, he's in the best defensive player bubble. But I personally think Reggie White, that's a good rant. Why? My buddy's a diehard Niners fan. He's actually the dude we're going up to a restaurant opening at 4:34 my time. I had John Henderson on this roster too. John Henderson's on the legendary Jags. We could have included him. I think he's only a 91 overall, so he still wouldn't have started. But yeah, kind of fucked that one up. Shout out to John Henderson, legendary Jacksonville Jaguar. But then again, look at that. We're 3-4. We're not looking too hot right now. Peyton Manning is struggling. I don't know why he's struggling. But we'll rock and roll this one here against Atlanta Falcons. Maybe we can get a win that can, rejuvenate the back end of this season and pull us back into things here. What's going on, everybody? Am I doing Florida State? I already did Florida State. So type in, I don't know, what's the keyword here? Just legendary FSU rosters, legendary Florida State rosters. I already did Florida State. We may have won the Super Bowl. I don't know. I think it was one of the better ones. What about Josh Dobbs? Josh Dobbs is not better than Peyton Manning. Heath Shuler, Peerless Price. You know, we can't get everybody. I don't really know who Heath Shuler is. It sounds familiar, but Peerless Price. I know he was definitely a big time. I remember more so on the Atlanta Falcons, but I know he played for the Bills. Maybe we could have included him as a wide receiver. But yeah, if you guys haven't checked it out, the next one is going to be the Texas Longhorns. Hopefully we'll be done this sooner than later, so then we can jump back and doing the all-time Madden Greats. And the Madden Greats is one that, you know, I can admit every now and then there's maybe an omission here in the legendary college roster, but the Madden Greats, we got all the best. Literally, if you were the highest overall in your position on a team, you're going to be in that motherfucking roster. Notre Dame's in it, yes. Stanford is not. Stanford, unfortunately, did not make the cut. Let's go Denarius Moore with the big-time stiff arm. Oh, fuck you. Cyan. Get a real name. Alright, see if we get Jason Witten here working in the middle. We'll just throw it to Cordero. Legendary Ohio State, yes, I think they're number 3. Again, if you're new here, we're going from 25 all the way down. And we're on, Tennessee is number 9, so we're going to number 8. I think Ohio State is 3, so they'll probably be getting done early next month. I don't know, it depends on the rate that we get some live streams going, but I don't know how many I'm going to be able to get in next week. Maybe 2, so that could be maybe next week you see the Longhorns and number 7, which is Nebraska. So Longhorns and Nebraska are up on the clock, but I don't know how much time. I think I'm going to be fucking dead after the draft. Oh, come on, Jamal Lewis. I know I am the GOAT, thank you. Do Syracuse legendary roster with Jim Brown. Who else is there? We're going to have Jim Brown and Donovan McNabb, and that's going to be the entire roster. Are you going to do Washington? I already did Washington. They were the first team we did way back when. So like I said, guys, a lot of the big teams have been done or they're going to be done. I'm going to say right now, when I was looking at the list, the only real omission, in my opinion, was Stanford. I really thought Stanford would have made it, but I guess they did not. Miami would be a good one to do. I already did Miami. It was very fun. I think we won the Super Bowl with Miami. Or we either won the Super Bowl or lost the Super Bowl. But again, that episode has been done. I mean, personally, I wouldn't rewatch if I was you guys in a full 2-hour live stream. But it may be worth just going back and looking at the rosters and seeing what players I use. You may find that interesting. Bo! Any thoughts on UCL? Who do you think's winning? I don't know. Are you saying UCLA or are you asking for Champions League? If it's Champions League, it's got to be Juventus. Get one for Buffon. If it's UCLA, uncertain about Josh Rosen. So there you go. Double whammy. Answer both questions. Justin Hunter with the drop. Fuck off. Travis Henry is Tennessee's all-time leading rusher. Valid point. But is he better than Jamal Lewis? Is he better than Arian Foster? There's a lot that, you know, there's different criteria. For certain positions, I will go with who was the better in college. Oh my God, that was terrible. Why'd I even throw that? This is my first man. I literally woke up like 45 minutes ago, so a little rusty. But yeah, I tried to go for best college, you try to take the best of both worlds. Best players in college, best players, you know, that eventually turned it around. But yes, Travis Henry was good back in the day. Remember, he spent some time with Denver. Didn't he do some stupid shit, though? I am not, man. Our wide receiver coverage sack on every fucking play. Come on. USC is on the list. USC is coming. Why is Brain your Twitter profile picture? Because who getting money that brain? Shout out to Lil Dicky. Just, you know, what I felt like making it this month. Oh, my God. Someone get open. Make a fucking play. You should do an NCAA gameplay for 18 season. Well, now that I'm a little bit bigger, what happened the last couple years is I always did a weekly college video, and it got shit off reviews, so that means I just took it as people don't give a fuck about college. But now that I'm a little bigger, I may do some college videos again next year. And yes, I use NCAA as that's a pick 6 there. Terrible. Maybe we need to get Tyler Bray in here. I'm going to be completely honest with you. It's our wide receivers. I haven't seen one play yet. We're going to switch up the playbook. One play where our wide receivers have gotten open. Why don't you use these legendary rosters in NCAA? Because my capture card, I don't think. I have the Elgato. I have like the top of the line Elgato, but for it being. This is embarrassing, man! The fuck? I can't do anything. Can't do anything. I don't have a capture card for my fucking Xbox 360 right now. So I'm really hoping that NCAA comes reverse compatible sooner than later. Or maybe I'll look at it buying like a cheap capture card so I can get NCAA. Or maybe I'm just stupid and I gotta refigure out how to hook up my Xbox 360. But I would love to play NCAA again. You should do preseason rebuilds. What does that mean? Preseason rebuilds. There we go! Finally, fucking production. Do I have Arian Foster? Yes, he's the backup running back to Jamal Lewis. Yeah, explain. What's a preseason rebuild, huh? You should do Florida Gator franchise for instance. I would love to do that because they suck. Well, they don't suck now, but there would be actually a point to rebuilding. Last time in NCAA 14, Gators were still fairly good. Wasn't a point. You just, you know, how do you rebuild what was already good? We had to do a Chip Kelly rebuild. Is Michigan coming up? I think Michigan is number three, maybe? Number three or number two? They are definitely coming up. It's Peyton Manning with his goddamn noodle arm. Dante Stallworth, the wide receiver? No, because Dante Stallworth blocked me on Twitter, so fuck that guy. Do a legendary Notre Dame roster. They are on the list. They will be coming. Just fucking pick me off, fam. Alright, let's stop fucking around. We gotta go to a go-to play, even though we just gotta make this score a little bit more respectable. Where's Peerless Price? He's too busy being in my all-time greatest name roster. Sorry. Why did he block you? Dante Stallworth blocked me because about 3 years ago. It was on my personal Twitter. About 3 years ago, on opening day, he just randomly said, man, can't wait for football. Like, who the fuck are you? You're some jobber free agency wide receiver. He said, can't wait for opening day football. And then I just tweeted at him, why don't you go fall out of a hot air balloon again? And then he blocked me because he fell out of a hot air balloon while he's, like, proposing to his wife or something. So we got absolutely bodied. Wide receivers didn't get any goddamn separation, which is pretty damn bad. Maybe we need to add a Peerless Price. You know what? I'm going to do that right now. I think that's what we need. Because I admit, that's a pretty big miss on a roster because I've heard of him. So that's what we're going to fucking do right now. I'm going to get Peerless Price's stats, and we're going to fucking add him to this right now. And he'll be our number one wide receiver. Because I think our top wide receiver is a 93. I think we can get Peerless Price at least. He'd probably be better than fucking Denarius Moore. Peerless, look, his middle name's LaCrosse. Jesus. You look more like that. Here's what goes in. You guys are getting first-hand experience of how I make my rosters. Except this one's going to be a lot more lackadaisical. We got Peerless. Oh, come on. We got Peerless Price, wide receiver from the University of Tennessee. Now, was he much of a speed receiver? I mean, shout out to Peerless Price. Looking at his stats, though, he had pretty much one good year back in 2002 with the Buffalo Bills. 1,200 yards, 9 touchdowns. Ever then, I don't know. Was he injury prone? What's going on with that guy? 5,000 career receiving yards, 31 touchdowns. We'll just keep everything as is there. We'll just juice his stats up here a little bit. So Peerless Price definitely was much more aware than this. Give him 93. Played a lot of time in the league. We'll give him a nice 91 speed. He's a 5'11", 190, so his strength will stay down. Probably a decent jumper. Up his carrying, his ball carrier vision, his elusiveness will come up. Spin move, juke move, catching. It's college roster. We need some help here. So we'll give him 95 catching. Literally, we need something drastic happen. So we'll give him 95 catching, 95 route running, 83 spec. 86 catch traffic, and we'll give him a 95 release. There you go, Peerless Price. You got top out. You're not even 90. All right, well, it's good enough. Maybe that's enough to be able to turn things around here in this goddamn franchise mode. Price was real fast, you said? He was real fast, huh? That sounds like 99 speed to me. We'll touch that up there. Go. We'll give him 98, 97, and 95. There we go. We got a burner here. Timmy Turner. 92. All right. Tied. Now, where does he go on our depth chart? Do they automatically put him in there? Look, they don't. I would have been fucking idiot just leaving him off the starting gig there. My apologies for using bad language. I'm starving. All right, let's move on to the next week. Hopefully, this is good enough. As an LSU fan and Saints fan, Fournette better not go to Carolina. He's probably going to Carolina. Preseason roster are rebuilds with preseason rosters. What does that mean? Isn't every roster a preseason roster? I don't get it. I'm confused. I don't get the premise. Don't curse, please, for fuck's sakes. Jesus Christ. All right, 5-5. All right, we're rocking and rolling here a little bit. Hey, Peerless Price was the answer to all of our prayers. Are you happy Arsenal beat City? I was fucking ecstatic. Aaron Ramsey is terrible. But luckily, we got that big 2-1 victory, baby. All right, now we're going up against the even though the record was terrible, we're not going to beat the Chargers. They're pretty much insane in the brain in this game. 6-6. All right, we got the 8-4 Saints. Let's see what we can do. See if we can fucking rock their world. When's the football movie live stream? You know what? I think my girlfriend might be over late. We might do it Wednesday. We might do it Wednesday night. Don't put me on that. I think it probably will be more a weekend thing, but it is coming soon. It will be a dual commentary, I guess, with my girlfriend. You should help me work with Mr. Hurricane. You should. You should certainly help me work with Mr. Hurricane. I'd love to fucking do a video with that guy. He's pretty much the only guy I think I would get along with in the YouTube community. Why are the Saints 95 overall? Oh, yeah. So, I guess if you're new here, the rosters that we're playing against are the legendary NFL rosters. So, this is like the all-time Saints legends that we're going up against. Are you doing a live draft or just a post-review of the draft? What we're doing is, the plan was forever, and I was hyping it up and I looked like a fucking liar, was I wanted to live stream during the draft. I wanted to have just some Madden going on in the background while I could watch the draft on another TV or whatever, and we just talk about the draft during that. I'm just one TV too short to be able to do that this year. I really hope that maybe next year we can make that a tradition forever long I do YouTube, that every year during draft night you can come watch me, maybe NFL Network in the background. But yeah, I'm one monitor too short, and I don't want to, like, live stream the draft on a computer and stuff, because it's in Philly. I want to hear all the fucking boos. I want to see all the picks. So what I'm going to be doing is, after every pick, there's a 10-minute window before picks, I'm going to make, like, a quick, probably 5-minute or less video about every single pick, and within the comment section there, we can all talk about the pick. It's going to help me out, I think, in views, so it's good on a YouTube side of thing, but it's also just the best way to talk about each specific pick with you guys. I was looking literally at everything. I was like, Discord server. I don't really know what that is, but someone was suggesting that. But yeah, it looks like 2018 will be the first annual live stream draft, which I think no one else really does that shit. I think it'll be pretty damn cool to do. Just didn't have the logistics to do it this year. Do you get NFL Network in Canada? Yes, we do. I watch it all day, every day. And tonight actually is Mike Mayock's mock draft. And Mike Mayock's pretty much the only guy I like. And yeah, I'm actually going to watch that tonight at some point. Justin Hunter, there we go. Any credit to Wenger for the Arsenal win? No. None whatsoever. I don't think we won that game because we had three in the back. I think we won that game Because Alexis Sanchez put the team on his motherfucking back, though. There we go. Peerless Price. Oh! Jukes living shit out of 40 there. Delvin broke his fucking ankles. What time? We're starting right at the draft. I'm literally, whatever. I think the draft starts at 8 p.m. Eastern. So, assuming the first video you're going to see is right after the Myles Garrett pick. Now, the only dilemma I'm having is, do I want to, like, follow Twitter? Because, obviously, with NFL Network, when you follow draft, nice touchdown there. Boom. Roasted. If you follow NFL Network, it lags behind. So, then that way there, I may be, like, you know, maybe a little bit more lead time and make my videos. But if I follow Twitter, where the tweets, people like the beat writers and stuff just spoil the picks, that probably might help me out to get videos out quicker and more efficiently. I don't know, because that kind of ruins the fun of the draft. But I'm thinking maybe I'll do that. I'll mix and match because there's some teams I don't give a shit about who they pick. I'll just make sure the Eagles picks a surprise, even though I'm sure, at least on Twitter, people are going to be already bombarding me before. Because they'll go like, oh, they're going to a commercial break before the Eagles pick. But I don't, maybe not. They probably have real time for the Eagles pick because it's in Philly. So who knows? You should do a series with NBA players on NFL teams. I don't know enough about the NFL to do that. I don't know enough about the NFL. I clearly don't know enough about the NFL. I don't know enough about NBA really to do something like that. Maybe. Maybe if I'm running low on ideas. Then again, I did a fucking video with my girlfriend where we made a team based off of NFL players' wives and girlfriends. So there's no low that I won't stoop to make a video. When's Mayock's draft? I think it's at 9? Well, 8. I think it's at 8 you got your guys' time. It's at 9 my time, I believe. Why don't you have Sean Bryson at fullback? Because we use the Bucks base roster here, and I felt unless your fullback is a monster, is he better than Mike Allstott? Probably not. You're off to Purdue for football, so I'd like to be in Eagles Connected franchise mode in Madden 19. You know what, bud? If you remind me next year, and you officially can show me you on a Purdue roster, I will fucking make you a first-round pick in my game whenever the fuck you, whatever, that'd be 2023, 2022? I'll do that. That's something that I always do for my subs. Even though it sounds kind of creepy that I'm creating you in my game and you're fucking probably six years younger than me, I'll do that. If you honestly are a solid football player and you tweet me out your official college stats, I will put you in one of my connected franchise modes. I think that's the least I can do. If you can watch me blabble on like an idiot during football camp, at least I can do is put you in a video. The booze will be outrageous. That's exactly what you want. Did you see what Warren said? The preseason rebuilds are rebuilds with... Like I said, I don't get that. Stop spamming it. I don't understand. It doesn't make sense. Preseason rosters. Every fucking rebuild I start out with is with a preseason roster. Preseason rosters are like... Oh, come on, Peyton. Boom, baby. Let's go. Big time TD. Did I see what Warren Sapp said about Myles Garrett? Yeah, him being lazy, but Warren Sapp's also like a fucking drunken idiot now. So I wouldn't worry about what Warren Sapp says. Even though QB Killa is the man. I think Warren Sapp's word and reputation is not nearly what it used to be. Do you think the Bears will draft Jonathan Allen? I still believe the Bears will draft Jonathan Allen. Looking at the Bears, I don't understand the safety. I don't understand the need for Jamal Adams unless they just straight up want like a bunch of good safeties. If I'm the Bears, I think Marshawn Lattimore, even though that's a risky pick anytime, like how many times is a picking a cornerback really high work? Like I can't remember off the top of my head the last time there was a legit top 10, I'm a pure cornerback. I mean, you got Jalen Ramsey, but he's like a defensive back. I mean, Justin Gilbert was like the last one. I remember he was a fucking bust. Mo Claiborne, bust. Eli Apples, I don't know. I wouldn't say lived up to a top 10 pick. Or it might have been 11, but I can't remember. But yeah, personally, if I was... Sanchez is to Arsenal what Teal was to Eagles. Except Sanchez actually wants to play like he gives a shit. Fournette will be there at number 8. Panthers don't need to trade up. Maybe. Man, the Jags. I know it's like the popular pick, and everyone kind of just jumps onto those kind of picks. You see, like, oh, 9 mock drafts that Fournette going to the Jags. Surely he must be on their board. But the Jags, they could reinvent their team by getting a Leonard Fournette. Clearly their offense, for as good as they are and all the players they have, it's not working. And there's no way in hell, he made a couple moves on the offensive line. Even though Brandon Albert, as that was terrible, we just fucked that one up. Brandon Albert wants a new contract, but Fournette could make Blake. It's one of those things, if you truly view having a run game to improve Blake Bortles, you kind of have to go after Fournette. Even though Christian McCaffrey is a much better fit for the Jags offense, Fournette is Fournette. Where do you think Reuben Foster falls? Reuben Foster is, I would say right now, a top 10 pick. In terms of talent, I think it's going to be really tough for the Saints to pass on him at 11 if he's still there. Even with all the off-field stuff, I don't think his stock's going to slip too much. Is Corey Davis going to be there at pick 9? He will 100% be there at pick 9, I think. Unless the Titans really surprise everyone and take him at 5, which I don't think they will. I think Bengals, Bills, Cardinals are probably the big three, I would say, to pick in Corey Davis. Maybe Philly's still in that. I don't necessarily think anymore Philly's going to go wide receiver in the first round. Jags have Chris Ivory and Yeldon. Why would they need another running back? Well, clearly Chris Ivory wasn't working. I like Chris Ivory as much as anyone. I thought going into last year that was a really, really good signing. But neither one of those running backs was that good. And like, it depends on how the Jags evaluate it. If they say that it's because their offensive line, maybe they won't go running back. Maybe they still believe them. But Fournette is better than both Ivory and Yeldon. It's not even close. I think Ivory's pretty much done. He's up there in age, man. Ivory must be, what, 30 now? So you got Yeldon and Fournette. That could be a nice two-headed running back combination. Yeldon has fairly good hands. Underrated hands for TJ Yeldon. You should do a series of biggest draft busts of each position. Well, I kind of did a draft bust connected franchise mode, like a one-off, and it got like 70,000 views, so that was fucking awesome. But, yeah, maybe. Oh, okay, there we go, first down. I don't really know how I'd do that. Like, why would people want to watch a video where guys suck? Maybe if I said, like, if draft busts weren't terrible, what would they look like? I don't know. I'm not really running low on ideas right now, but I'm sure probably middle of next month, I may look at doing stuff like that. Thoughts on Mike Williams from Clemson? I'm a little worried about his ability to get separation at the next level, but he's a baller, man. He's a beast. First round wide receiver for sure. I'm a Bengals fan, hoping for Thomas or Foster. I do not see Solomon Thomas slipping that far, even though I'm not as high on Solomon Thomas as other people. Foster would be a good pick. I think the Bengals are in a really good position. If you don't view offensive line as like their immediate need. Oh, come on, hot this shit. I mean, Bengals could go running back. There's going to be running backs there if they want. If they don't view, I heard rumors they're trying to ship Jeremy Hill. Running back, there's going to be wide receivers. There's going to be fucking corners. There's going to be linebackers, defensive linemen. Everything should be there. A little bit of everything's going to be there. Not even offensive linemen if they want it to reach. So I think Bengals are sitting in a very nice position. What if you... Oh, shit, I can't read. All right, guys, the chat is going off. I can't keep up with all your questions if I don't answer you. I'm giving you a pass to slightly spam. You may repeat your question upwards of 3 times. And if I don't answer by that, then sorry about your damn luck. I'll fit that in. Ah, shit. Maybe a what-if scenario. Like, what if the Chargers look like if they didn't trade Drew Brees? Very, very valid. That's kind of what I do in Super Bowl or Bust, though. For some ideas, Super Bowl or Bust. Like, I have an idea coming up is what if the Miami Dolphins got Drew Brees instead of getting Dante Culpepper? That's pretty much what led to Nick Saban leaving the Miami Dolphins. But, yeah, some ideas like that are great. I'm obviously not going to really remember them in the live chat, but when I do Super Bowl or Bust and stuff like that, I always ask for you guys to give me feedback in the comment section below, and I always troll through those comments. Because it's always a good video idea every now and again. You guys show that you're capable of being creative geniuses. Will I ever do a Vikings Michael draft? I assume that's a mock draft and I'm getting to it. It's come. All the mock drafts are done. Even teams with first round picks. Actually, who's coming out today? I'm recording this one earlier. Tonight, Rams are tonight. Vikings are tomorrow. So yeah, those are finishing up the draft. As we win a game here, very nice. You should do a preseason refuck. Oh, it makes no sense. Minter was Ray's replacement. We have linebacker depth. That's what I always thought, kind of. I mean, obviously, getting a guy like Reuben Foster, as like, there's always those picks. Like, Philadelphia Eagles, I've seen plenty of Derek Barnett. We don't need a defensive end, but it's always a position that if someone goes down, it's just one of those things, you know, hindsight. If fucking Minter goes down, then, wow, Reuben Foster would have been a beast to have. So, I mean, that's where best player available comes in. But, yeah, I agree. I think with Vincent Ray, Vontaze Burfict, Minter, linebacking core is solid. But if one of those guys go down, maybe Nick Vigil can step up. I don't know necessarily. People saying John Ross falling to the top of the second round. How do you feel? I can see that. Man, if you can't stay healthy, you can't play. And he fucking broke the 40-yard dash time, which is incredibly impressive. But what happened? He fucking pulled up at the end of it, just adding on to the injury concerns. What happens if the Panthers trade up number 2, select Fournette? Do the 49ers get Trubisky at 8 based on schedule? What do you think the 49ers? It's tough for the 49ers to pick. I think still best player. They might be able to trade down with at 8. Maybe Marshawn Lattimore could still be there. They need help at corner. Man, we might be able to fucking make a playoff push here. Let's go. Let's rock and roll. Peerless Price. Shout out to that suggestion. Are you going to do a connected franchise move with updated rosters after the draft? What I do, for all you guys that aren't here, it used to be super, super clickbaity, but we, in the last 2 years, we've made it, you know, what it is. Every year, because it's the down period, some people get invited to Madden YouTuber tournaments. Other people have to fucking fight and claw to survive here. Every day, well, not almost every day, I'm going to be doing my roster predictions for Madden 18. So, for example, one day you're going to get what I think the Eagles rosters are going to look like in Madden 18, all the overalls, and my reasonings behind that. I do that for all 32 teams. I've done it for 4 years now, so that's kind of what I do for that. In terms of that, what do you think about the Giants selecting Deshaun Watson in the first round? Yeah, it makes sense. You got to get ready for Eli Manning's backup. I think Eli probably, what, 2 years, 2-3 years at the most? If you can get a quarterback that you believe is the answer there, go for it. How do you think the Titans will do without Mariota? Well, isn't he coming back? Shouldn't he be ready for week one? He'll be fine. Best case scenario for Atlanta. I personally think for the Falcons, there's two players, in my mind, three players maybe, that should be available. That would be great picks for them. I think Taco Charlton or Charles Harris on the defensive front to get more edge rusher, have another big-time pass rusher aside from Vic Beasley. Or Chris Chester retired. He was a starting Garrett. Forrest Lamp. I think Forrest Lamp may be the safest offensive line prospect in wherever they're picking 31. He could still be there. So I think I think the Falcons are sitting in a nice spot because an edge rusher and offensive lineman, interior offensive lineman, should slip to them there. Okay, I kind of get what you're saying, Jordan, for the preseason rosters. That sounds, I don't know, that doesn't really sound that fun to do, to be honest with you. My Chip Kelly Cowboys rebuild, how'd you roll? And thanks, I'm glad you enjoyed that. Oh, shit. Oh, there we go, Denarius Moore. Stretched it out, I think it was a loss of one. Should have rained that shit. Who would best fit for the Detroit Lions? Maybe Hassan Riddick. I think personally Lions got to go linebacker now. Jared Davis would be a good fit. Maybe Reuben Foster slips to the Lions. Makes that a no-brainer pick. As for some reason, we're punting the ball here. I got friggin' half hour. Jesus Christ. What if the Eagles get Darbo from Michigan round 2 or 3? How would I feel? Definitely not round 2. Definitely don't think we should go wide receiver round 2. Literally, even though I think John Ross is lots of red flags, I might be able to get behind selecting John Ross in the second round if he's still there for the Eagles, but there's no wide receiver, I don't think, that's worth a second round pick. Maybe Zay Jones? Maybe. C4, if I give you 4.3 million coins, could I get a shout out in one of your vids and could you make a squad build or something like that? See, I'm not going to be honest with you. That would be fucking awesome, but I would just make a parody video of that. That'd be my opportunity just to clown on Ultimate Team. But I would give you a shout out for sure if you want to give me 4 million coins. But best believe that video is probably not going to be serious. Texans record prediction. I don't know their schedule at the top of my head, but looking at their roster without a quarterback, 7-9 maybe. They get by 7-9 with, I don't know, man. It's like I said, it's two reasons. Someone suggested that I do a full predictions for every single team, but there's a lot of teams that big things could happen between now and the draft, so it'd be kind of asinine to make that kind of video right now. I can do one for the Eagles because I know my Eagles, all right? I know my goddamn Eagles. You want to know something? Three Eagles beat reporters did their mock drafts, their first mock drafts today. You know what their draft went? Gerryon Conley, Joe Mixon. Who's been saying that for like 3 fucking months now? This guy. Well, not 3 months. I've been saying Joe Mixon forever. But I've been going. I'm on the Gerryon Conley hype train since Sidney Jones went down injured. I'm the goddamn pulse here in the Philadelphia Eagles community. How do you feel if the Eagles took McCaffrey at 14? I'd be happy. I'd be all right with that, I guess. What do you think about Cooper Kupp? Probably best route running in the draft class. And I think he will slip a little bit because of his poor testing at the combine. But he'll be a good wide receiver. I think he'll be good in the NFL. I'll do it. All right, man, fucking do it. I don't know how we're going to do that, but fucking let's do it. I don't know why you'd want to give me anything like that. Most likely to be a draft bust, Trubisky. Unless the fucking Jets take Deshaun Watson. I love Deshaun Watson. I'm pulling for Deshaun Watson, but I wouldn't put money on him. I wouldn't bet my house on Deshaun Watson pulling through. I hope he does. Really do. But I don't know, man. Who do you hate more, EDP or Nelson Agholor? EDP. Zay Jones or Cooper Kupp? Zay Jones, for sure. I love Zay Jones is a monster. Beasta, you can hear me before you see me. I got Zay Jones in the trunk. Zay Jones. Zay Jones. I don't even know if people know. Remember that song. That was fucking junior high for me. Mixon is a late first round pick now. Absolutely. Maybe. I don't think so. I think most teams have Zay Jones as a third round pick, and that's if you really like him. And then I think some teams have him as a second round pick. But I saw one mock draft of Bucky Brooks had him go in the first round of the Packers. I don't see that happening. Where do you think Jabril Peppers will end up? I could see a team like the Patriots, maybe. I don't think he goes in the first round. I never really did think he was going to go in the first round. Oh, come on. Who do you think is underrated in the draft? Jared Davis from Florida. Marcus May from Florida. I can say that from firsthand experience. I think both those guys are going to be really good in the NFL. I think Zay Jones has potential to be the best wide receiver in this year's draft class. And he's second round, third round grade. Jerry McNichols at the running back spot. Jalen Reeves-Maven, linebacker from Tennessee. Speaking of the Vols. I haven't even used my fucking Vols wide pick this. Yeah. Do you think Atlanta will be a repeat Super Bowl contender? I do not. I think they'll definitely be a playoff team. They didn't really lose. Who'd they lose? Who they lost? A starting offensive lineman. Is that it? Off the top of my head, I can't really think. Oh, no. Come on. Jared Davis might go in the second round. I don't think he'll slip past the Raiders. I think the Raiders will be happy to take him. Oh, that interception is going to fucking cost us, I think. We got a Bob Costas here. 100% don't trust draft. Yeah, they do that, man. That's why. That's why I like Mike Mayock. Not only do I value Mike Mayock's opinion a lot, but he only does one mock draft, and he does it the goddamn week of the draft. What do you think about the later round quarterback prospects? I think they're not bad. If you consider Davis Webb, he might be my favorite overall prospect in this year's draft class. You got Nathan Peterman from Pitt. I mean, I don't think he's better than Tom Savage when he was coming out of Pitt, but he's another solid guy. I personally don't see anything in Josh Dobbs, but I'm not going to bet against him because Josh Dobbs is the type of athlete and type of quarterback that 100% for some reason will be good in the NFL. So I don't want to be like, oh, remember when C4 said Dobbs is going to suck? I think he's going to suck, but I'm not going to say he sucks because I could just see me eating my words on that one. Oh, come on, Peyton. Throw it in front of Patterson. Fuck. Who should the Chiefs draft? That's an interesting one. Quarterback, if they really believe. I mean, I can see Andy Reid getting all giddy over Deshaun Watson if he's still there because I want to shit on Alex Smith, but really last year wasn't Alex Smith's fault. Literally, no one on the wide receiver corps can make a play. Maybe a quarterback. I think if not, if you don't go cornerback, I think you maybe look at replacing Derek Johnson or getting his eventual replacement or add another corner to play aside from Marcus Peters. Who's better, Todd McShay or Mel Kiper? They're both terrible. Both terrible. Mel Kiper is like the most out of touch. Like, all right, let's just try to not murder our quarterback there. Where will Dalvin Cook go? I think he's definitely going to slip. He's always been, you know, I've never really been a fan of him. It's easy for me to hate him because he's Florida State, and I hate Florida State. I don't know. Maybe Bucks. Maybe 19 at Tampa Bay. Oh, why'd you throw? Oh, come on. Catch that shit. You gotta catch that shit, motherfucker. I'm a Tennessee fan. I think Dobbs will suck. Like, literally, it's like, he just doesn't look good. He has no accuracy. His pocket presence is terrible. Like, he could be an absolute project quarterback, and maybe someone can make something out of him. Turn chicken shit into chicken salad. Maybe. Can you do a hype video if the Eagles draft Joe Mixon? Yes, I will. I don't necessarily know how I'm going to approach making videos and talking about the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh round. I may just do a recap at the end of the day, plus Philadelphia Eagle videos. My favorite Florida player in the NFL. Well, first it was Tim Tebow. But, oh, fit that in. Yes, let's go. Fucking get it. Favorite Florida, maybe Joe Hayden. No. Oh, it went to overtime. Yes, it went to... Oh, what the fuck happened there? All right, let's get a touchdown in this shit. Favorite Florida... yeah, that's a tough one. Maybe Joe Hayden, though. Just because I think Joe Hayden's probably the best Gator I've seen that actually was really good in the NFL. I like Carlos Dunlap a lot, but he got suspended, I think, in his final game for, like, speeding and shit, and it cost us. Jordan Weed ran to the Redskins, so, you know... Plus, Jordan Reed's, I'm going to say right now, Jordan Reed is much better in the NFL than he was in college. He was really good in college, but he wasn't anywhere near. Fit that in. Where's the touch, Peyton? You're 99. All right, well, this is a fucking excellent start. I think we're going to have to go for it. I don't trust our defense. Peerless Price! Who said... Oh, my God. Shout out the guy who suggested put Peerless Price. He didn't really have great wide receivers. That is true. Those are facts. As Peyton Manning takes off and he gets absolutely rocked. But still, 5 rushes for Peyton Manning. All right, let's settle down here with the running attempts. What quarterback will be the best fit for the Steelers in this year's draft? Looking at what they have. Well, I mean, all the quarterbacks, probably Trubisky. For what, when they're picking, Davis Webb. I think Davis Webb would be a good understudy to have. Oh, my God. Oh, please be on the defense. Shit, our defense came up big. Only need a field goal. Are you a good baseball player? I'm all right. I hated baseball, to be honest with you, but I'm all right at baseball. Thoughts on Michigan cornerback Jordan Lewis? I think he's pretty much a prototypical Jim Schwartz defensive back prospect. Definitely will slip from the off-field shit. tested fairly bad, so that in part with, like, I think he's a domestic. He punched some chick. What is it with fucking college prospects? Do they just not get taking shit from women, you know? God. Well, I think he's solid. Okay. Boom, Jason Witten. Oh, let's go. Let's end this right now. We might have a shot at making the playoffs here, fellas. Vols team, but Bucks jersey. Because I keep fucking up. I use the Bucks cream skull. Kind of looks like the gold of Tennessee. I just haven't fucking... I just keep forgetting to put the jerseys on. But big time game-winning TD for Peyton Manning to Jason Witten. Do a 2018 7-round mock draft. Yes, because I can fucking see that far in the future. Don't think so. Why do people like mutt YouTubers? They post the same stuff every day. That's something that, you know, you need to ask other people. Because that's what I see. Like, I don't have a problem if, like, there's just not enough people that play mutt. They balance it out. There's just too much. How do you feel about Charles Harris? I actually low-key like Charles Harris. Just hope to God Philly doesn't touch him at 14. That'd be devastating. Look at that first in the division. Let's play this one. I'm running a little late on time, but we'll fucking do it. We'll make it work. Okay, let's see if we're going to put our little Vols, our poor attempt at a Vols jersey here. Look at that. That kind of, that's pretty damn close, to be honest with you, aside from the pants. Thoughts on Jalen Hurts? Gonna be interested to see how he plays without Mr. Lane Kiffin. Thoughts on TJ Watt? A lot of upside. Don't think he's a finished product yet, though. He's only been playing like linebacker for a couple years. Still learning the position, but the fact that he was as good as he was last year for Wisconsin, I think he'll that the potential alone will get him drafted. He's probably one of the highest ceilings on the defensive side of the ball, but more of a project player than I think people think. All right, well, it's pretty simple. We win this game, we're going to the playoffs. Oh, come on, defense. Oh, of course. Great. Best linebacker for the Eagles. Probably Reuben Foster. There we go. What college team are you doing next? Texas. Texas is up on the clock. Maybe Tuesday. All right, come on, old man Witten, get open. We'll just show a check down here to Ron Rivera, son Michael Rivera. What do you think of Chad Kelly? I would want him on my roster. I wouldn't overvalue him though, because it sucked to overdraft a guy like that with off-field issues. But I don't think he's gonna be a Johnny Manziel type, personally. Off the back foot, Jason Witten. Let's go. We need that. Who's the most overrated player in the draft? It's a tough one. Cook? Maybe Dalvin Cook? Thoughts on the Steelers' schedule next year? 5-0. I don't know their opponents, to be completely honest with you. I haven't looked at any other schedule aside from the Eagles, Cowboys, and Giants. T.J. Watt, I already said, man, T.J. Watt, high ceiling. I think he's a bit more of a project player than people think, but a high ceiling, nonetheless. Great genetics. Thoughts on Texas A&M QB safety? I think Trevor Knight might want to transition to a different position. Ran a good 40 time. And Justin Evans, he's good, man. Big time hitter. He has to go to the right scheme fit, though. Trubisky, if you consider him for the number one pick. Yeah, that's true. That could be a bust. Who goes first, Mike Williams, John Ross? Mike Williams. Do you think Deshaun Watson's underrated? I think he's fairly rated, I guess. That'd be the proper way. I think he's rated about as high as he should be. His weaknesses, which are for sure weaknesses, are pretty accurate. I'm pulling for him, man. One of my favorite players from college last year. Clemson is one of the teams I enjoy watching. He's a beast. Browns, Bears, Vikings, Ravens, and I forgot the last one. Okay, the Steelers, out of those games, maybe Baltimore's the only one I'd be worried about. 4-0, 4-1, maybe. Oh, let's go, Jamal. All right, we'll burn a timeout here. Get a touchdown, get back in this. Could the Ravens be a playoff contender? I just don't see their offense being able to match their defense. Oh, I get a message. Cool. Thoughts on Jalen Reeves-Maven. Big fan. Reminds me a lot of his play style. I don't necessarily know because Michael Kendricks obviously ran an incredible 40 time for a linebacker. But his play style reminds me of Michael Kendricks. The good and the bad. Oh, man. Luke Kuechly's good. People are saying the Broncos have the hardest schedule. I think statistically the Broncos have the hardest schedule. Ah, fuck, we'll kick a field goal here. Bengals playoff win, what do you think? I know you're a Bengals fan, but I don't know. That offensive line scares me. Oh, come on. He fell forward. That should be a first down there, right? Don't give me fourth. There we go. Nice. We need a touchdown here, 100%. EDP or Peyton Manning? Oh, that's a tough one. Neither. That'd have to be a neither. I've seen many people predicting the Cowgirls go 9-7-8-8. What do you think? I don't think they're going to be as good as they were last year, but yeah, I think that's going to be the log jam between the Giants, Eagles, and Cowboys. Like, whatever team gets 10 wins, I think will win the division. I think 10 wins wins the division this year. Okay, pass interference, just got decapitated. All right, come on, Denarius Moore. Need more production. Ha-ha. Oh, he held on to it. Nice. All right, let's go no huddle. Oh, that was bad. Let's just use C4 special and get in there. Do you think Derrick Henry would develop to a Pro Bowl caliber running back? I don't know, man. Depends how quickly they get rid of DeMarco. I think DeMarco might hinder his development a little bit. There we go. Needed that. Need our defense to bail us out. How many things the Seahawks have with their core? 2. I'm a Raiders fan. Do you think it's messed up we get a home game in Mexico City? Yeah, it does, especially because it's your last year. I think you want as many games in front of that home crowd as you want. Oh, my God. Our defense is just shit in the bed here. It's going to be a loss. 34-24. Fingers crossed we did enough to get into the playoffs. Unlikely. I got to go anyway, but we'll see what we can do here. I'll stick around if we made the playoffs, obviously, but who knows. Jabril Peppers to Atlanta? Maybe. I mean, if Dan Quinn drafted, I'd feel confident that he knows how to use him. What's your opinion on Forrest Lamp, best interior offensive lineman this year? Should the Ravens draft a wide receiver in the first round? I think if the Cards play that way, yeah, Corey Davis would be a good fit. I don't really know John Ross. I mean, you got Perriman as your burner already, but I think Corey Davis is there. That'd be a solid fit. All right, did we make the playoffs? Moment of truth. And we did. We got into the wild card. Very nice. All right, let's quickly look at our final regular season stats, though. Peyton Manning, 4,600 passing yards, 38 touchdowns, 15 picks. So good season from him. Running the ball, we got 1,300 yards and 12 touchdowns from Jamal Lewis, 408 touchdowns from Arian Foster. In terms of receiving, Cordarrelle Patterson, 93 receptions, 1,300 yards and 12 touchdowns. Witten and Hunter both had solid seasons. Price came on late, but, big-time playmaker. Maybe it was enough to give us the push to make a playoff run here. Defense side of the ball, Majit, 135 tackles, 105 from Al Wilson. We got 13 sacks from Reggie White. He's the GOAT. 4 picks from Al Wilson, 3 from Majit, 2 from McDaniel and Carter, and 3 from Justin Coleman. All right, let's go. Divisional rivalry, big-time rivalry matchup here against the Atlanta Falcons. Excuse me. Barnett to the... I'm going to hate that, man. I'm going to fucking hate that. That's like looking at like the current draft board, who we might get. Barnett's going to be my least favorite pick. I would hate that shit. Since this is a Tennessee legendary roster, what do you think the Vols next year? Heavy turnover. They lost their starting quarterback. They lost Kamara, who's the biggest playmaker on their team. Defensively, they lost. I think it's going to be a rebuild year for them. Not going to be terrible, obviously, but I don't think they're going to... Don't get aspirations of winning the SEC. Do you like Ben Bower? I do like him. I love the thumb up to the ass move he does on the bottle of pileups. It's kind of... You can't teach that, right? You don't learn that in training camp. You have to have the mentality to do that, the savage mentality. All right, nice. We get the computer guys a touchdown. Thank you very much. Oh, we should have used the... I always forget using the rosters in this. Because I always look at the chat during like the loading screens and shit. Corey Davis or Mike Williams? I like Corey Davis more. Let's go Peyton. Best QB in college next year. Josh Allen, Josh Rosen, Sam Darnold. Best quarterback? Mason Rudolph. There's one for you. I can see him being the best quarterback next year. Oh, that's a bad kick. Don't worry, though. Aguayo makes it. The transfer from Florida State. Yeah, rebuilds. Oh, yeah. That's a good thing in college. Rebuilds 1 year. Well, I mean, depending. If you have terrible recruiting, Jim McElwain, could be a little bit longer. Best QB prospect for next year. Like I said, keep an eye on Mason Rudolph from Oklahoma State. I don't know. I got to see. Because obviously Sam Darnold's popular, but I need to see more. It's too early for me to say. A lot of flags this coming year. I mean, like Rosen's coming off an injury. You got Josh Allen from Wyoming. He had good tape, bad tape, really inconsistent. Quarterback's going to be interesting. I think this is like, it's easy to say. Quarterbacks need to have a good year next year, but like really, it's gonna matter this year because they're so, like I don't know, man. It's tough for quarterbacks. Fucking course, you let that happen. Will Greer EDP. Will Greer for sure. I don't mind him. He just got into those Lane Johnson Mexican supplements. Can't hate. Most overpaid player on the Eagles. Vinny Curry, unfortunately. Oh. That will keep the clock running. Alabama will win again. Most likely they will, yes. Unfortunate as that is. It's going to be tough to beat Bama. It's always going to be tough to beat Bama, but they got a good roster this year. They got a good roster every year, but do an overpaid CFM. That's not a bad idea. Maybe I'll do that. Get out of bounds. Maybe we can get a field goal here. Make it a one-point game. I love my corner strike. Maybe Peerless Price. Oh, what a grab. We might have one more shot. Maybe we could do a four verticals into the end zone here. Okay, the fuck, who does? Okay, there goes. Who the fuck does have four verticals in their playbook? Jameis Winston or Mariota? I like Mariota a little bit more, but I think they're both good. You should do an unrealistic rebuild with salary cap off. Too many people do that on YouTube. Haha. Shots fired. Oh, let's go. There we go, baby. Peerless Price is a monster. We need to create an Instagram. I always thought Instagram is for girls, to be honest with you. I'm going to have to get on. I got a Facebook, though, guys. At PapaC4 on Facebook. I'm trying to use that more. Oh, rest in peace, Peyton Manning. Got that big old head on him. Best put to get. Oh, yeah. That's what everyone else. Maybe, should I get try to trade for Khalil Mack or Julio Jones? In that rebuild with salary cap off. What do you think about Luke DeRio as Florida's quarterback? No chance in hell. That experiment is done. It's Peerless Price. Shout out to the guy who suggested we do Peerless Price. Let's get it. Julio or Antonio? Julio. All right, tie ball game. Very interesting. Third and 10, putting us in a very precarious position here, Sim. Oh, yes. Find that gap right in the middle. The sweet spot. Another one. Let's go. Go no huddle. Maybe we should run this shit. Papa C4 on Facebook. No results. What the fuck? One word. I think it's one word. I don't think I spaced it. There we go. Easy TD, baby. Someone just liked it. I got a notification. Shout out to whoever just liked my Facebook. Dope. Shit, tie ball game. Oh, what the fuck? Beast Mode TV, maybe. Oh, what the fuck? Have you embraced the C5 thing for your son? Maybe when he gets older. If he's old enough that, like, he can understand football, make a clear sense, maybe he'll make a debut as C5 on the channel. There we go. People liking my Facebook. It's a great thing. Should get this first. Like I said, field goal. I'll be all right with a field goal here if that's all we can get. Even though these motherfuckers are going to try to at. Beast Mode TV. All right, there you go. Nice. Thanks for checking that shit out. Eventually, you know, once we get a little more bigger head, we may get some merchandise going. I don't know. Rocking and rolling. Goddamn surgeon out here. Let him fucking freeze me. The best field goal kicker on YouTube, baby. We'll get this shit.
Swag.
Just like that, moving on. Even though my fucking buddy's probably waiting out in the driveway. Don't give a shit, I'm live streaming, baby. Do a first round draft picks team. I think I've already done that. Pretty much I did this whole thing where we did, well, maybe first overall picks I didn't do. But forever before we did these as our live streams, we did live streams of all the first rounds from drafts, I think 2007 all the way up to 2017. So even check that out. Always plug. Go check that shit out. Do you know that Tyrod Taylor has more rings than Fletcher Cox? I don't get that. Because he won a fucking backup with Baltimore? I could have definitely put Michael Pilardi. I remember those guys. We just, oh my god, look at the Texans, or the Redskins, 15-1. Okay. Okay, Pimpin. See you. Oh, we could have used the uniforms. Fuck. And now here's the also plug to follow me on Twitter. If you don't follow me on Twitter, beastmode_TV. You should be. That's where I do most of my business and dealings. I think it's in the description. I don't know if I updated it right, but that's where I always post. A lot of times my live streams are impromptu. And sometimes I go for suggestions of what you guys want to see in a live stream. You think using UCLA would be a good team to use in NCAA? Probably. Yeah, you got a great quarterback there. Solid defense. Biggest sleeper, C4, do you play head-to-head with fans? See, that's the thing. When I say I don't do anything with fans, it sounds like an asshole. Literally, I don't really like playing online, man. I don't necessarily know if it's my internet, but I find, like, man, it's just a really laggy online experience. So I don't enjoy to play it. So because I don't enjoy to play it, I don't play with subs and stuff like that. I may change that in Madden 18, but I don't really have, like, a lot of free time. When I have free time, I'm doing a live stream or something like this. But yeah, there's a reason why. It's not because I hate playing with people. Oh, that's a first down. Nice effort. Nice effort. Well, you were both Scarborough declared for the draft. Maybe next year. Maybe not. If he doesn't think that he's going to... I mean, it's a tough class going up against Saquon Barkley and Darius Geis next season. But, you know... What's up, straight cash? I'm fucking making paper, bro. You should do a team from 1 to 99. Like, numbers? It's kind of tough. That require a lot of work. Now, if someone could go ahead and do that for me, if someone could make a Word document and do that, I would fucking put the team together and play with it. That'd be so much fucking time to try to, like, look through all the jersey numbers. Son Riddick, good fit for Atlanta. Yeah. You get fit in one of those outside linebacker roles. Thoughts on Jarvis Landry saying they'll sweep New England? Yeah. No. Did you watch any college football spring games? I did not, unfortunately. I've seen a lot of recaps, though. quarterback controversy in Auburn. I've seen Felipe Franks seems like he has the gig down in Florida, but I have not. I assume that like most teams just stream it on like their official websites, but yeah, I haven't seen any of it, fortunately. Oh, risque. C4, after the stream, can I give you the coins? Do you follow me on Twitter, Samuel? Because, like I said, I got to bounce after this. But if you follow me on Twitter, we can work something out. If you're actually going to do me something like that, that'd be fucking dope. I don't know how I'd make it, but I have to make it worthwhile. And how do you send me? Like, literally, follow me on Twitter. You can fucking... If you don't have Twitter, maybe we can work something out. My email is on Twitter. My Beast Mode TV email. Oh, there we go. Easy TD, baby. GG, easy. Thoughts on Josh Dobbs? I'm not as high on him as other people. Does Derwin James have a chance of winning the Heisman? No. I think it's going to be quite a long time until you see a defensive player win a Heisman again. He's a beast, though. Derwin James is a monster. But I don't think he's as good as Jalen Ramsey. Oh, there we go. Peerless Price. Let's go. There we go. Gotta speed this up here a little bit. When will Lamar Jackson... He'll probably go next year, I think. I don't even know. With Lamar Jackson, if he's smart, he might want to wait out another year. Oh, my God. Embarrassing coverage. Who do you think Joe Mixon's going to get drafted by? Come on, bro. Philly. Come on, computers. Get this one out for me. There we go. Big time victory there. Moving on, man. We're fucking rocking and rolling. Durin went to your high school. Went to a high school. Man, I would not want to play against that guy. That's the kind of dude that got the growth spurt before everybody else. Going to the conference championship. Who's going to make the biggest reach for a pick? Probably anyone for, you know, quarterback. All right, we're taking on the Rams. Let's go. All right, we're going to try to remember the unis here. How crazy is a rage video going to be if the Eagles pass on Mixon? Not crazy. Like I've already said, man. Like, if they pass on Mixon, I think we have to be fine with the pick. There's going to be a rage video. Don't get me wrong. But it's not going to be bad. I think the bigger rage will be if fucking Philly drafts Derek Barnett. There's going to be a good rage video right there. Best possible player available at 48 for the Vikings. 10 to edge towards best available. At 48, there's going to be some good offensive linemen. Posich, the center, would be a good pick. He's versatile, play anywhere on the interior of the offensive line. I think there's going to be good. That's a good round. At 40, round 48, there's going to be good value at offensive line. So they can get maybe a Deion Dawkins, Ethan Posich. I thought the Eagles were going to draft McCaffrey. They could. I mean, no one knows who's going to draft who. Could there be two SEC teams in the playoffs this year? I don't think this year, but I mean, obviously, I don't want to shit talk my Gators, but I think there's going to be a point in time when Bama and Georgia might be able to. I think, as much as it pains me to say, I think Georgia is more likely to be the next big SEC East team than Florida is, but who knows? Maybe Felipe Franks is going to be the answer. You're meeting Derek Barnett this weekend because he's shooting a commercial with my dad. Well, fucking get him to sign something and send it over to your boy Beast Mode TV. Because if he's a Philadelphia Eagle, I have a feeling they're going to draft him. I'd love a piece of merch like that, bro. That'd be sick. That'd be better than any Super Chat donation anyone could ever give. I actually don't have anything autographed by a Philadelphia Eagle. I've told the story when I was in Philly last. I kind of yelled at Nelson Aguilar because I saw him walking downtown Philly. But that's I've never really got to see. There was the meet and greet that the week I was going. I think Trent Cole was there. I missed out on that. But literally, I would probably pay $1,000 to like meet Brian Dawkins. Oh, come on. Royce Freeman thoughts? Solid. Needs to stay healthy. Thoughts on Sean Kizer? I think the Bears are going to try to get him with their second-round pick. I think he's high ceiling, but definitely a project player. Dalvin Cook is much better than Christian McCaffrey. In what way? Similar production. I think Cook I think Cook is good. Don't get me wrong. It seems like when you pick and choose between players, you're saying one of them sucks and one of them's good. I think they're both solid. McCaffrey, for my money, is a much better player than... He's good at everything Dalvin Cook is good at, if not better. And Dalvin Cook has terrible lateral movement. Fucking Garrett Bowles, right tackle, almost beat Dalvin Cook in like the three-cone shuttle. That's bad. I paid zero to meet Anthony Munoz. That'd be pretty goddamn dope. How rich am I? I'm fucking pretty rich, to be honest with you. In Canadian dollars, which means nothing. What playbook I'm running? I'm running the Bucks playbook. I love this play with the running back out top. Oh, I didn't see double safety. Ooh, that was risky. You think Reuben Foster can fall to the Eagles? Absolutely, he could fall. I would take that. Even though he's not a need, I would take that. Met Rod Woodson. Fucking lucky. Oh, come on. That's going to be holding on me. Would you rather have safety Keanu Neal or Carl Joseph? What do I need? Do I need a cover guy or a guy that plays in the box? If I had to pick, it'd be Neal. You met Joey Bosa. Did you tell him that he's fucking overpowered in Madden? He's the most overpowered player in Madden. Yeah, that is they have to lose Michigan. I guess that kind of spoiled what team we're using for Michigan. We're going to make a fucking Super Bowl run here, and I'm going to be late for dinner. That's what's going to fucking happen. You met Fletch? Nice. He seems like a cool guy. Oh, that was a bad pass. Would you rather have Christian McCaffrey or Alvin Kamara? Christian McCaffrey every day of the week. We don't know. Alvin Kamara got like kicked off of fucking some team, like Texas or something like that, and he had to go to JUCO and then came back to Tennessee. Give me McCaffrey, who's the choir boy, you know? Oh. We're going for it. Oh, there we go. Big ball chip. That's a Chip Kelly play right there. Who's going Rookie of the Year on offense or defense? Offensive Rookie of the Year, probably Fournette. Defensive Rookie of the Year. My God, are we going to win this shit? Let's let the sim take over, because literally, I got to fucking go here, people. I assume we're going to make a playoff run. So we got to go. We gotta get this shit going. There we go. 38-10 victory for the Vols. They're going to the Super Bowl, led by Peyton Manning. Very un-Peyton Manning-like to perform well in the playoffs. Have you seen the video of McCaffrey doing, he was doing fucking, I don't know, it was like a ladder or something like that. My God. Give me that every day of the week. Yeah, he was on Alabama and got kicked off. Give me the choir boy and Christian McCaffrey. That's rock and roll. Wow. This might be like the biggest turnaround. We were like fucking 4-5. Added Peerless Price to the roster, and now we're on one hell of a run. Let's go. Thoughts on Josh Reynolds from A&M. Like him. Solid ceiling. And we're taking on the Patriots. Ooh, that's a nice matchup. How's my lateral movement? It's probably terrible right now. When's Nebraska? 7th. They're in 2 videos. We're doing Nebraska. Next video will be Texas, and the one after that will be Nebraska. And the quarterback for Nebraska, we don't know. It's going to be fucking Tommy Frazier. It's going to be Eric Couch. Who knows? Russell Wilson? No, we already used Russell Wilson. If we draft Mixon, he's weekend rookie of the year. That's maybe, but the way I see it is that he's not going to be on the field as much as he will be, because I think we're still going to use Darren Sproles on a lot of like pass catching downs. When Darren Sproles is gone, I think then you're going to utilize Joe Mixon to his full ability. But I think with Sproles being on the roster, it might be tough for Mixon to get that Rookie of the Year nod. People are sleeping on Marlon Humphrey. They're not really sleeping on him. He's just, his tape, he's athletically good, but his tape wasn't that great. Vince Young at quarterback for Texas. You know it. I feel like the Patriots are going to draft Mixon. Because Patriots have like 9 running backs on their roster right now. They are definitely going to get another one. As, oh my God. That was terrible. Is C4 phoning this in? Because he wants to go eat some fucking dinner. Oh, there we go. The computer getting us touchdowns. Here we go. We're going to win this thing. 14-7, 3 turnovers already for Tom Brady. What? Not saying I don't like your channel. Do you know any other channel that has bear stuff? I do not. Oh, rest in peace, 26. Ty Law just got murked. Oh, that's bad. You want to see Colt McCoy over Vince Young on Texas? I don't think that'd be the popular opinion on that one. Oh, and here come the Patriots. Oh, that was good coverage. Throw the old man Witten there. Get a field goal. Hey, we're good. All right, later, Nugs. Oh, they turn over the red zone. That should be enough. There we go, guys. We got to see this because my buddy's on his way. Just got that text. I can go eat some fish and chips. This is a body bag. Absolute body bag performance here. That must be nice for anyone to see. The Tennessee Volunteers bodying up the Patriots. 52-20. So, yeah, that's going to wrap up the stream here, guys. Thank you for tuning in, as always. Great live stream once again. Looking at my schedule, obviously, I hope you guys can tune in on Thursday, where there's going to be 32 videos coming in your sub box talking about the draft. Looking at the next day I might stream, could be Wednesday, maybe. Maybe Tuesday or Wednesday. It's going to be one of those days. We'll be doing the Texas rosters. But thank you all for tuning in. As always, check me out on Facebook at PapaC4. Follow me out on Twitter at BeastMode_TV. And until next time, it's C4 saying peace out.